A good idea is a momentary thought. The execution of it is what takes the time to actually construct it and solve the problems of construction. So, you know, that's a 3-week process for me.
Of the public art program are to create really memorable places throughout the community, places that intrigue you, that make you see the place differently, make you want to return, make you think, oh, let's go for a walk and see that really cool thing. And so part of that opportunity with the artwork is to create another layer of experience, of attraction that brings people here, that helps them really know their community in a deeper way. About 3 years ago, I had the idea that we should have a work by Patrick. Actually, when you decide that you want to try and have a work by Patrick, his waiting list is a couple of years long. He does 10 projects a year all over the world. It turned out that he was available right at the point at which this park was being completed.
It started with us hiring a crew, a tree services, to cut down some of these limbs around these trees. Then, of course, artists came up, and that was the beginning of everything. It's definitely 3 weeks out of the ordinary for Parks and Rec and for myself too. Once in a lifetime opportunity for me, and I think for the city, that we're gonna see something like this being built in one of our parks.
My dedication is to using a site well, finding the right scale and a level of mimicry of the site itself. There was a need for things to be just a little bit more than a hidey hole or a hovel or a bivouac. It just needed to have a little more pop to it. So I thought having things look out at you from under the tree line might be exciting and add to a level of interest that would pull people over and off the walkway and take a look at it.
And I think most people who encounter his work have a whole series of emotions of sort of being startled and amazed and confused, and then ending with a sense of wonder and awe. I really hope that we could create that kind of an experience for people here in one of our parks, that it'd be something that you weren't necessarily expecting to come across, but as you explored the park, you come across something that on a deeper level makes you really appreciate the hand of the artist in a natural setting, the use of natural materials in a park, sort of art that is of the land in a certain way, that connects with your sense of imagination and fantasy.
The bulk of the structure has been made out of willow, and then the red stuff you see on the structure is red twig dogwood. And most of the material has come from Jackson Bottom Wetlands Preserve, or a wetland right next to the Gordon Faber Rec Complex. And then we've pulled some from the Pacific University's B Street Farm, and also a site in Cornelius called Free Orchards Park. The project itself has really helped people feel a part of the park. The volunteers played a critical part in building this. They've been able to interact with their fellow citizens and kind of build community, and it just helps the city have more of a small town feel when the citizens can get together and have a project to work on.
I volunteered because I had seen Patrick's work in Boise, Idaho. His book is in the library, and so I had looked at that. And I'm a basket weaver, and so this was like right up my alley, using natural materials, and just a fun project to be part of.
It was something totally different than what I do, and that was kind of what intrigued me, because I thought, okay, let's learn something new. Let's get involved in this. And it's something in the community you can say, I helped with this.
It's a group thing where you participate with something and you feel this ownership kind of thing, and you want to protect it and feel great about what you did and hope that it's going to last a while.
Because Patrick uses so many volunteers, to help him construct the piece. There is a large aspect of community building, of people that have participated by actually bending sticks and shoving them into the structure, or going out into the wetlands and cutting and bundling sticks to bring back. And then all the people that walk along the path and see this happening, that are making it a part of their routine to come and see every day or two how things have changed, and to talk to Patrick or the volunteers.
We came over before anything was happening, and it was just the trees, and we knew where it was going to happen. And we've worked it into our schedule to come over and watch the process. And so we've seen it from the beginning, and it's been like magic for them. Patrick came over and talked to our students and was great with them, explaining that he got started by playing in the woods and playing with sticks. And so I think they can envision now that they could do that. When we've come over, Valerie, who works with the Parks Department, has been great at getting us involved. So one day we came over and the trucks were full of bundles of sticks, and she said, does your class want to help unload the trucks? So we got to do that. So they feel really connected to the project, which has been amazing for them.
I've worked nonstop for 30 years, very enthusiastic about the work. There's a big challenge, and building things and working with new sites, new organizations, new people, all of that is constant flux. That's a bath of ideas. It's great to feed that need by moving from one community to another. I'm still working out new ideas with the same material, that the sites are sometimes consternating and demanding, but sometimes they give you good ideas about how you could do something you've never done before. Your dedication is to being a sculptor, to being in the world of ideas, to share what you have, to garner reactions from people and see how you do.
We've had other public art projects here in Hillsboro that did involve community, but this is one so unique in its connection to nature. Patrick is really trying to create an environment where people will literally interact and engage. They're going to go inside of these heads and look out the windows, the eyes, and he wanted them to really go back between the trees and be really up close against the bark and the texture and the smells of the woods as a way of really more deeply experiencing nature in a little microcosm space.
To the park and seeing this taking place and taking shape in our park here, it was a wonderful experience. And I can see that having a big impact in this community. People are coming by and then all of a sudden they stop and, wow, what's going on here? What are you guys doing? There will be more people coming to visit, especially now since it's finished. So I'm looking forward to meeting those people and letting them know what happened here.
We have made it a priority to incorporate art in all parts of Hillsboro, downtown, out here at Orenco Woods. And it's just a wonderful way to show, you know, our expressions of imagination, of beauty, of nature. And there's no better example of that than what's behind me and what we have all been working on. So thanks to Hillsboro. You guys are amazing.
Patrick Dougherty is an extraordinary artist. He takes the most humble of materials, the lowly stick, and transforms it into a majestic sculpture.
A good community project, and it brought a lot of people together. Who would have thought that sticks could make something so wonderful?
The title. When I fell in love, it was head over heels. And that's what we're calling this. Thank you.